Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mangs, and I welcome you guys to the long-awaited Fire Emblem 8 Pick My Edits Let's Play. Yes, it is finally time. Oh my god, it feels like we've been waiting forever. At least I feel like I've been waiting forever for this one. This is the best and absolutely the most advanced Pick My Edits Let's Play that I have ever hosted. I mean, I'm not gonna talk like I did all the work, because I didn't, but the amount of effort that has been put into this Pick My Edits compared to the two other ones, which was Fire Emblem 6 and Fire Emblem 4, absolutely immense. We have so many custom portraits, we have so many edits, every single character and boss has been edited in some way, so many amazing edits proposed by you guys, of course. I was the one who picked most of them, but nearly every single edit comes from the comments section. There were some people who were able to, you know, make edits personally because they knew me and shit, but aside from that, most of the edits done to this ROM comes from the comments section, and oh boy, what an amazing experience this is gonna be. So before you close this video and run off to the Discord chat to download this ROM for yourself, and yes, this Pick My Edits ROM will be available in my Discord chat, which you can find a link to in the video description, head over to the channel known as the Pick My Edits Download Central, where this ROM, alongside a Google Documents listing all the changes, will be available. But hold your horses, don't close this video just yet. I will be releasing the ROM a couple of hours after this video goes live. Why? Call me a little bit selfish, but I actually want people to watch this video, not just close it and go play the ROM for themselves. Call a little bit of a business strategy right here. You know, I'm kind of in the YouTube business, so I kind of need, you know, I trust that most of you guys will watch this Let's Play anyway, but I think that if the ROM was available right now, a lot of you guys would just close the video, run and play it, you know, and that wouldn't be very profitable for me. So I'm going to wait a couple of hours, 2 to 3 hours after this video goes live, until I post the ROM in the Pick My Edits Download Central, and I will be announcing it to Discord to everyone using the hashtag everyone to get your guys' attention and inform you guys that the ROM is now available, at which point you can download it and you can play this wonderful hack for yourself. But for now, please stay around, watch this episode at least, and let's have some fun. So, before I start, just gotta give a huge shout out to all the people that made this Pick My Edits possible. Arguably the most important job done by the one and only Datagne. He was the one who helped me out with my Fire Emblem 6 Pick My Edits run. And Datagne has been an absolute hero. He is one of the people working on the Staff of Ages hack, which I have expressed my opinions about multiple times on this channel. It is the best hack in the world. And he has been working tirelessly for hours and hours and hours, fixing so many bugs. And we've had a team of 5 beta testers. Yeah, I do believe there's been 5 of us. And these beta testers have been playing the game multiple times, scouring it of bugs. I think in total we have probably fixed over 50 bugs. I mean, I'm saying we, but Datagne was the one who fixed all the bugs. My beta testers were the one who reported them. So thank you to my entire team. Of course, Calvin, one of the beta testers, also did a lot of custom portraits, which has really made this Pick My Edits so much better than what it would have been otherwise, and you'll see when we get into it. I know you guys are not here to just listen to me talk, so we're just gonna jump straight into it, and when I come across changes, I will talk about them. I won't go over all the changes at once, that's gonna be way too much, but as I said, in addition to the Discord link, there is also a link to a Google Doc in the video description where you guys can go and read about all the changes if you haven't already. I've also listed the growth rates of all the characters there, because there have been a lot of modifications to characters and their growth rates. So, regarding what difficulty you should pick, we've disabled easy mode, and the reason behind that is that the easy mode just doesn't go well together with hacking, because the tutorial can really bug out. So easy mode is disabled. You can pick between normal and difficult. Now, the enemy growth rates has been increased by 40%. We tried 50%, it was way too high. Enemies just started capping every single stat in the late game, and it just got way too much. So we decided to bump it down to 40%, but some of the bosses have been buffed a lot. So the bosses are a lot stronger than what you might expect. If you play normal, you're gonna get a challenge pretty high above hard mode in the vanilla Sacred Stones. So this will still be a pretty difficult run. So for anyone who's not a seasoned veteran, I definitely recommend you pick normal as your difficulty. Difficult is going to be hard. I've gotten this confirmed from my beta testers. They say the game is grindingly hard, if that's even a term that can be used. Like, it's very tough. You will run into capped enemies in the late game. The bosses will be an absolute pain. We're of course going to be playing difficults. Let's go. I am so hyped for this. Now, normally in a pick my edits run, I would skip the story, and I'm definitely going to skip this story right here because this one's unchanged. But I'm actually going to be watching most of the cutscenes because you can see so many funny things on the cutscenes, such as many edited characters. So you can already see some funny things here if you pay attention. I'm sure you can see it already. And here's the main character. Emblem is the main character of the game. And Seth has been replaced by Jagan from Fire Emblem 1. This is pretty cool. Now, Emblem, oh my god, she's such a fun unit in this Pick My Edits. I'm going to show you how amazing she is. Trust me, it's fantastic. And yes, Ephraim is indeed named Mary Sue. So I'm not going to be watching all the dialogue. I'm just going to be watching the cutscenes generally, just to look at the characters involved, because you do get to see some sneak peeks of eventual villains and stuff like that, like here. Narshan, and what I think is hilarious with this one is the dialogue for Walter fits Narshan so well. I am Narshan, the Moonstone, Greta's finest general, and you're just a corpse who doesn't know he's dead. So how often do you get to see this, ladies and gentlemen? Jagan versus Narshan. Only in this Pick My Edits. And of course, Jagan runs away. I gotta say, I love Amelia's portrait. And she gets the ring in life, so... Here's another villain. It's Bata the Beasts! You there, Renee Dogs! Alright, so we're of course going to be talking about the different characters and their growth rates. I'm just going to be doing a little bit of cycling through colors. These are the settings that I prefer to run with. So, here is Emblem. She replaces Erica. And her growth rates are actually unchanged. She uses She uses Emblem's growth rates. And she's a recruit. So, on first glance, it would appear like Emblem is very similar. Aside from the fact that her con is a little bit bumped up, of course. Pepsi Max replacing Vulneraries. This is a change from the Fire Emblem 6 Pick My Edits. And she has the Regen Life, which is of course Ephraim's weapon, but she can use this one. So by the looks of things, Emblem doesn't really... she doesn't really seem all that different. I mean, her growth rates are roughly... they're exactly similar to what you'd expect. So what's so special about Emblem? She can summon Emblems. She can summon Emblems. Not only that, these Emblems can fight. They're like phantoms, except that they don't fly. This means that we get to see Emblem die a lot. So, Emblem is a recruit that summons other Emblems. It's absolutely fantastic, and the weapons that get summoned are fantastic. It's random every time, and you can get some crazy ones. So yeah, at first glance, this may seem really shit, but trust me, Emblem's a lot of fun to play around with, especially when she levels up. And we get to see Emblem die a lot, which is fantastic. Alright, let's talk a little bit about Jagan. Here's Jagan. Of course, he replaces Seth. Now, Jagan actually has his Fire Emblem 1 basis, which, you know, aren't very high. They were good for Fire Emblem 1, they're not very good in Fire Emblem 8. But to compensate for this, he has Fire Emblem 6 Carol's growth rates. A little bit of a homage to Fire Emblem 6 Pick My Edits Marcus, which of course got ridiculous because he had Fire Emblem 6 Marcus base stats with Carol's growth rates. Jagan, not going to be as good as Fire Emblem 6 Pick My Edits Marcus, but he's still going to be pretty fucking good because he'll get perfect level ups every time. In fact, he'll get +2 in certain stats if he's lucky. So Jagan will be a viable character throughout the entire run, I'm fairly certain. And of course, he has a pretty fast support with Emblem, which is nice. So, naturally, these guys will rape Emblem. With 40% growth rates, you start to notice that enemies get a lot stronger. Take a look at Bata here, for example. Compare this with O'Neill's stats, which is the character he's replacing in the vanilla gameplay, and you'll see that they're much, much, much higher. So Emblem obviously will get absolutely raped, so we're just going to be sending Jagan in here to deal with these guys. So it's kind of funny to see, even with his Fire Emblem 1 basis, against enemies with 40% increased growth rates, Jagan still one rounds these guys, which is hilarious. I mean, I find it very fascinating. Of course, he doesn't double. So Bada won't start moving until the next turn, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna move Jagan into this forest. Now Pepsi Max, it heals for 15 hit points, so it's a little bit better than your average Vulnerary. I think I'm actually gonna move him like this. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Now, steel weapons in this Pick My Edits have plus 3 might, so steel weapons are very good. Silver weapons actually has less might, they have 3 less might than usual, but they are effective against monster units, so silver weapons are not as good as they are usually, but as I said, they're good against monsters, so they'll be monster slaying, which is kind of cool. Now, let's see if Amelia can kill this guy. She cannot. I think I'm actually just gonna summon another Amelia. Whoop. Now, I could attack this guy. I summoned an Amelia with an Iron Lance. But I actually don't want the Phantom to get the kill, so I'm gonna move the Phantom into the forest. Now, since these Phantoms don't fly, I do think they get a cover bonus from the forests. Pretty sure they do. Now, normally, Phantoms that you summon in the vanilla gameplay... Wow, so Bada actually doesn't attack? Huh, that's kind of cool. Let's summon another Amelia. This is great. Oh my god. Alright, let's go. Who do you think you are? You think you can stand up to Battle the Beast? Yes, I do think I can stand up to Battle the Beast. Now, of course, Jagan is strong because the Steel Sword has plus 3 might compared to the vanilla gameplay, so he hits really hard. That needs to be said. Bop, bop, bop. Now, I'm actually not sure if this is a route map or if it's a kill the boss map. I've never actually gotten past one of his cronies without killing O'Neill himself. Because you're not... Okay, it's actually a defeat boss chapter, which is kind of funny. Let's try to kill him with Amelia. There you go. I kind of sad that she doesn't have her little garbage... her little trash can head in her actual model, but, you know, that would be very, very difficult to program in. Alright, so let's just kill this guy. Now, I'm going to be playing the two first chapters, I think. Maybe even the third one. We'll see. Now, of course, giving Jagan boss kills is going to be very, very viable in this Pick My Edits. Very viable indeed, because, of course, he levels up extremely good. And the boss experience does him very well as well. So again, I'm going to try not to skip through all the cutscenes here and actually watch some of them, because you can see some pretty fun things here. Princess Sheeta! I think that Calvin, out of all the portraits that Calvin designed, this one is actually among my favorite ones. She's so pretty. I actually don't know who he based it off, but I really like it. And here's Commander Baguette. Don't fuck with Baguette. Here he comes. This green mercenary sucks. Ha! That's what happens when you face my lance. Alright, poor Princess Sheeta. She got visited by the Baguette. Alright, so here's Baguette. He has a lot of luck, if I remember correctly. He has, like, ridiculous luck. And he also has a killer lance, so this guy's kinda nasty. But nothing Jagan can't take care of. I gotta be careful, because a lot of these people double Amelia. She's pretty trash, considering she has Amelia base stats. Da 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 ba bum ba bum ba bum bum. So I'm gonna try not to use my Silver Lance here, because honestly, there's no point. The Silver Lance has the same might as the Steel Sword, and I kind of want to save it for the I want to save it for when I meet the monsters, because the Silver Lance is gonna be really good against monsters. I think I'm actually just gonna keep Amelia on this forge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I'll keep the Phantom on this forge, because of course the enemies are drawn to Phantoms. They always prioritize them, for whatever reason. I don't know why, but the enemy is set to attack the Phantoms. I think it's because the Phantoms have 1 health, and enemies really like prioritizing units that they can kill. They get like a huge boost to their targeting mechanisms. It's kind of... I don't know why Franz says, is that Mulan? I think that's the Tan fucking with us. I don't know why. All right, let's take a look at the two new guys who joined us. So let's start with Bosswin. Bosswin, look at that custom portrait. He's so sexy. Comes with killer bow and a steel sword. Bosswin, of course, this is a reference to my very first randomizer, Fire Emblem 7 randomized, where Bosswin randomized into a nomad. Of course, the nomad isn't present in Fire Emblem 8, So instead, boss win is a pre-promoted ranger starting at level 1. But fun fact, he actually starts with the same base stats as he did in my Fire Emblem 7 randomizer. Aside from a slight boost to his speed, I believe. But his growth rates are doubled. They're Oswin's growth rates from Fire Emblem 7, but doubled. So his growth rates are actually really good, as you can see right here. He will most likely get one in every stat when he levels up. And sometimes he can even get 2 points in hit points on defense, because they're both above 100%. Boswin also has a hidden skill. He has the hidden plus 15% crit skill that Swordmasters and Berserkers get. So his critical rating is very high, as you can see right here. It's 50% crits. And he also comes with a killer bow. So Boswin will crit a lot, which is what he also did in my Fire Emblem 7 randomizer. So very cool. I love the custom portrait. It's a lot of fun to see. One of my favorite edits in the Spikma edits. That's why I picked it when I saw it. So, alright. And then we have Franz. Franz is a soldier, and he has Obro's growth rates from Fire Emblem Fates. So he's kind of the Lance. If you remember my Fire Emblem 6 pick, my edits, Lance had Obro's base stats and growth rates, and easily was one of the best units in the game. Now, he doesn't have Obro's base stats. He has something a little bit lower than that, but he has really good con and really good growth rates. And just for fun, he comes with 3 Franz Reavers. He can't use them. I must admit, this was a mistake on my part. I thought Franz Reavers were lances, but then I remember, no, they're actually swords. This is, of course, a reference to my Fire Emblem 8 Let's Play, where I lost Franz to a Lance Reaver, and I called it the Franz Reaver. And the Franz Reaver is actually a Lance Reaver that is also effective against horses, you know, just to add insult to injury. But he comes with them. He can't use them, but he can give them away, which is always nice. Alright, so boss win. Let's start by taking down. Now, probably just gonna use my killer bow just for fun. I could also use my steel sword, but he can't one-shot this guy with that, so I'm actually gonna... Yeah, I'm gonna do this. Ah, no crits? Come on! So I'm not sure if you can see this, but his arrows are slightly greenish in color. Now, of course, he doesn't shoot green dildos like he used to in Fire Emblem 7, but... Now, I'm actually going to swap his steel sword around so he can retaliate at that incoming soldier. Franz is apparently really good. I've gotten reports from my beta testers that he easily become one of the best units. And you'll see why when you see what he can promote into. It's actually a lot of fun. I'm not going to spoil it. Now, should we kill this guy? I think we're going to kill this guy, and then we're going to summon an Emelia to draw the other guys out. And I'm definitely going to kill the boss with Jagan. Always check Emelia's inventory when she summons. Absolutely check her inventory. You might be surprised. There's a lot of funny things she can start out with. What? She... Okay, you don't want to kill things with phantoms because they don't get an experience, but that's... Wow, doubled by a phantom. Now, of course, as Emelia levels up, her phantoms will become stronger. They'll level up with her. They'll, of course, always have 1 health. That will never change. But still, it's pretty funny. It's well worth it to level up Emelia now. We've actually made her useful. Who'd have fucking thunk it? Alright, so... I think I'm just gonna shoot down this guy with an arrow. Go boss win, 50% crit. Now, I'm gonna be pretty diligent in building supports, because I know that the endgame is going to be really hard. Now, of course, you can build supports in the tower, which is quite nice, but I'm not gonna use the tower that much unless I have to. Now, of course, you can grind in Fire Emblem 8, so that's kind of one of the reasons why I felt comfortable bumping up the growth rate so much, because you can always go to the, tower. And get experience. Of course, the tower is hard. With the 40% increased growth rates, the enemies in there are going to be much scarier. But you still have the option to go do skirmishes and grind in the tower. So if you do get screwed over, there's always that. Now, of course, in the next chapter, I do believe there's an armory. So we can definitely stock up on some supplies there. And we probably have to. The two characters coming up in the next chapter is, one of them is my favorite. Probably my favorite edit in this pick my edits. We actually get 4 characters in the next chapter, which is going to be a lot of fun. Debating whether or not I should include that in this episode or not. We'll see. We'll see what the time count is once we get there. Alright, let's see. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna soften this guy up a little bit with Boss Win. Like so. And we're gonna be moving Dragon over here. I guess we could... No, I'm going to move one of the Phantoms over here. And it would be nice if we could lure some of these guys over here with Franz. So I'm just gonna move Amelia back here. Oh, you can actually talk, but it doesn't do anything, so it doesn't really matter. Oh my... Oh, she has the Devil Lance! She has the Devil Lance! Oh, she killed... Oh my god, I love watching Amelia die! Alright, so what you saw there, ladies and gentlemen, was... that was one of the new lances in this hack. The Devil Lance works exactly as you think it does. And yes, Amelia's Phantoms has a chance to spawn with it. And they just backfire. It's just hilarious, really. Oh my god, I love this. I love this pick my head. It's so much fun. Alright. So Amelia, she has decent growth rates. Not fantastic ones, but she will level up pretty decently. Alright, let's give Franz another kill. Franz very fast. He's a very good basis for a soldier at his level. And I do believe he starts at a level 1, doesn't he? Yes, he does. So those bases are actually really good for a level 1 soldier. Especially considering he has Oberos growth rates. So he'll be a really good unit. Alright, let's get the kill with this guy. Now, of course, I'm going to try and get the kill to Jagan. I mean, either Jagan or Bosswin, they're both pre-promotes, so they both really enjoy the experience from the boss. So let's see, 8 damage. No, we can easily attack this guy. And it's a crit! And that's a one shot. Lol. Now, before we continue, I'm actually going to build some supports. I'm planning on using a lot of units. I'll explain why in the next chapter. So I'm just going to be cutting out the support grinding. We shall be right back. All right, so I'm going to be doing all the fast supports early on. Whoever can support with whoever, I'll just build them up immediately. Now, the reason why I feel confident doing this is because I'm most likely going to be using almost every single unit on the roster initially. Now, what I'm actually going to do when we reach the Erika Ephraim split is I'm going to be playing both routes. I'm just going to be letting this one play out in the background while I talk. So I'm going to be playing both routes, and how I'm going to be doing that is I'm going to actually split up the entire cast between Amelia and Marisu. And I'm going to be playing each chapter, I'm going to be playing one Amelia chapter, one Marisu chapter, and then I'm going to be playing another Amelia chapter, and then the other Marisu chapter. So I'm going to be playing them side by side, but, as I said, I'm going to split my entire army in two, so that it actually feels like I'm splitting the army in two and playing with both sides. At the end of the route split, when both routes converge, I'm either going to ask someone to hack it, so that I retain all the experience from both sides, or I'm just going to go and grind it up in the tower myself until I reach that level, so that I actually get to use both my units, or I can pick and choose units from both sides depending on which one I like the most. So it's just how I decided to do things. I hope you guys will enjoy that. Now I'm looking at the time here. We're a little bit over 20 minutes. You know what? Normally I like to keep my YouTube videos underneath 30 minutes, but I'm gonna give you guys a special treat today since it is the first episode. We can go a little bit over the time and we can play the second chapter as well. So I'm going to be doing that. It means I'll be going slightly over the time, but you know what? It's fine. It's the first episode. Hype is at an all-time high. Let's fucking do it. So, I don't think there's anything particular. Oh, never mind. Here's two new characters. Oh my god, this is so great. I fucking love this. Whoops. My bad. I needed to bring up the growth rate, so I have them next to me, and I accidentally closed the emulator. But I'm back now. So yeah, we just got to see two of the new characters right there. Oh my god. Bell and Boulder. Can't wait. Alright, let's go. Now, a little bit of a warning here. This chapter right here has a cutscene that might glitch out. I think I'm pretty sure I know what causes it. The boss, Bone, which is a Bone Walker, that's funny at it, he will attempt to destroy a village. I think because he's not a brigand, he can crash the game. So you see him right there. He's gonna go and destroy that village right now. And if you let him, I'm going to make a save state to see if it actually freezes the game. Here's another Reddit. Yes, it's Gonzalez. So if he does freeze the game... Yeah, this is why I didn't want to skip it, because yes, it is indeed Dorcas and Geb. And Geb is Dorcas's dad. Alright, I think I'm just going to skip immediately, because I don't want... Yeah, yeah, as you can see right there, this is what happens. The game freezes. Luckily, I did do a save state, and you can just skip past it. And again, I'm pretty sure this happens because Bone, he's a Bone Walker, comes with a Killing Edge and Pocket Wings. This was the Tan's way of fixing units starting out in mountains. If a unit is a class that isn't allowed to walk in mountains, he gives them Pocket Wings so that they won't bug out. But yeah, since he's not a brigand and doesn't have the ability to destroy villages, I think that's why the game freezes. There wasn't anything we could do with that, so just skip this cutscene when you do get to it. Anyway, let's take a look at some of the new units. Here we have Belle. She replaces Vanessa. And yes, she is indeed Belle from Staff of Ages. She can wield rapiers. Fun fact, she can also wield the Sigilind when it appears, because apparently the Sigilind and the rapier has the same weapon preferences. So if you can wield the rapier, you can also wield the Sigilind, which is kind of funny. Regarding her growth rates and base stats, I do believe they are similar to Staff of Ages. Belle has pretty okay growth rates. She is the main character of Staff of Ages, but Staff of Ages is pretty conservative when it comes to growth rates, so she's actually not that strong. I mean, she has pretty good speed and luck, but her strength growth is actually very low at 35%, but she does come with 15 base speed, so she will be able to double most everything she goes up against, at least in the first few early chapters. Her con is very low, but she's a sword-wielding Pegasus Knight, so it's really fine. So she should be fine. Okay, it actually still retains Vanessa's biography, which is kind of funny. So yeah, she comes with the rapier. Then we have a Boulder, Molder the Boulder. An amazing edit and an amazing portrait right here. Boulder has very good strength, skill, and defense, but very shitty speed and luck and resistance. In fact, his hit points, strength, and defense growth all above 100%. He also has capped con, so he's absolutely massive. But he only has a 15% speed growth and only a 20% luck growth. And his resistance is also pretty piss poor. So Boulder is a pretty good tank, but he's not really good at anything else. But he does have one extra move, since Armor Knights have 5 move in this pick my edits instead of 4. So he's actually pretty good. Not sure if he's viable. We'll see. And then, of course, we have Geb. Comes with a personal axe named Rape. This is a devil axe that has a brave effect. Be very careful with this thing. It has amazing stats, but it can kill you very quickly. So yeah, this is Geb. He has the same base stats as the boss Geb on hard mode. So his base stats are really good. His growth rates are so and so. I mean, he has very good hit point strength and defense, but his skill, speed, luck, and resistance are all pretty shit. But he does have a pretty good support with his son, which is very nice. So I'm probably going to be using Geb because I'm going to be using most units. And those base stats are still going to be very viable. We do have 3 very good pre-promotes, so we definitely have some assistance in getting us through the early game. Then we have Dorcas. Dorcas is Geb's son. He is Dorcas. His growth rates are a little bit improved from his Fire Emblem 7 self, and that's good because he definitely needs that. I do believe both his skill, defense, and resistance are all a little bit higher. But his speed is pretty shit still, though. But he has base speed of 10, which is nice. He also has his own personal axe called Dorcas. It has the description Dorcas. It poisons on hit. So, because poison. What happened to Dorcas? And he has... he starts out with 3... antitoxins, because he's Dorcas. He has learned from his mutton experience. But of course, antitoxins are named Pepsi Max Cherry in this hack, so it just looks really silly when you think about it. But yeah, let us start by rescuing Dorcas. Oh no! Belle doesn't have the con. Oh no, this is bad. That means we're gonna have to kill this guy now. Oh no. Okay, you know what? That's actually really bad. So I wonder, can Belle use Boss Wind Steel Sword? She can. Okay, so I'm gonna see. Can Belle kill this guy? Okay, this is good. Because, of course, since we can't rescue Dorcas, that means that Dorcas might die. So we're gonna have to kill Dorcas with Belle. Now, of course, Belle's custom animation is pretty sexy. Look at that! Da, 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 da. But that, of course, means that we're not gonna have the opportunity to recruit Dorcas right away. This means that we're gonna have to bring Amelia. We're gonna have to rescue Amelia with Belle and bring Amelia over here. And yeah, that could be pretty tricky, actually. So I think, yeah, we're just gonna move down here. I always hated Seth, aka Jagan's starting position on this map. He starts way too far back, which is a big problem. Now, I think I'm gonna be positioning Amelia right here on the armory to draw out this brigand. Now, I do believe that Bone actually doesn't move in this Pick My Edits. I think, I don't exactly remember why, but he doesn't. Okay, so they actually do not move. That's good to know. Right. Are you kidding me? Bell doesn't have the... Why is Bell's aid so shit? I'm pretty sure she is supposed to have more aid than that. She has 5... I think we should hotfix this, actually. I'm pretty sure Bell's aid is not supposed to be 4. Even in Staff of Ages. Is she? Because female Pegasus Knights, aren't they supposed to have like 20 minus con in their aid? So yeah, that's something that we definitely look into. At this point in time, I haven't released the Pick My Edits to the public yet, so there's still time to fix this before it goes live. There shouldn't be many bugs. I mean, there's bound to be a couple. And yes, instead of Slim's weapons in this hack, we have Devil weapons. We have the Devil Sword, the Devil Axe, the Devil Lance, and the Devil Bow. Every single Devil weapon imaginable. They have amazing stats, they give insane weapon experience, but they do have a 20% minus lockback fire rate. So, be careful. I'm just gonna stock up on some basic supplies here. Looks like you're full. In Norwegian, being full means drunk, which I always think is kind of funny. But yeah, I'm just gonna be stocking up on some basic supplies right here. I do believe you get a red gem at the end of this chapter. I do think you get it in this chapter, if I remember correctly, so... Alright, let's kill this guy. Woohoo! So we can sell that red gem and buy some more supplies. In my Fire Emblem 8 Let's Play, I did do a lot of shop... I used the armory and the battle preparations a lot. Alright, I already have the support, lovely. And that fucked me over quite badly, and a lot of people complained about that. This is kind of funny with Sacred Stones. You can actually unlock the supports really quickly, which is always fun to see. Alright, we do need to visit the villages, though. And I'm actually probably just gonna do that with Belle, I think. And that gives you a Mountain Dew, which are the elixirs of this Pick My Edits. Ba-ba-ba. Now, I wonder if Dorcas will actually attack that archer now. Okay, so this is dangerous. Ah! Oh, are you... You gotta be fucking kidding me right now. Alright, so that's fucking stupid. Now, I did talk to Datagne, and I did get him to fix the aid bug. So, yeah, that's taken care of right now. But I still actually kind of like my idea of giving... Bell the steel sword and killing this brigand, because it does actually kind of eliminate the risk on the first turn. Now I'm not sure if Bell has the aid to rescue Geb. She might. I think Geb has 18 con, so I'm gonna check, because I think Dorcas will be fine against that archer after he's healed up. Yeah, I can actually rescue Geb. All right, that's better, I guess. But I should probably should probably get Amelia over there anyway. Or maybe I should get Dorcas out of there so I can recruit Dorcas. And, yeah, talk to Geb with Dorcas. I'm just gonna have to pray that Geb doesn't rape himself again, I suppose. I mean, what can you do at this point? I mean, the backfire rate of the Geb axe is 30% minus luck. I do believe Geb has a base luck of 1. So that's a 29% chance to kill himself. But if he just hits 1, he'll be fine. He'll just need to hit 1 time, and he'll be fine. So, anyway, let's get Dorcas out of there. We then can go and talk to Dorcas. And we can also, let's see, we can actually use the Dorcas axe. No, we can't use the Dorcas axe to get a kill here. That kind of sucks. Maybe if we hit with the Phantom, we can. Let's see if we can hit with the Phantom. Let's go, Amelia, don't suck. There you go. We're gonna see Amelia die so much in this Let's Play. I fucking love it. Alright, let's see. Let's try it. Come on. What happened? No, Dorcas!
What happened to Dorcas?
Fucking hell. Fire Emblem. Build an army. Trust no one. Especially not fucking Dorcas. Alright, this is better though. Alright, so we gave Dorcas a kill. That's nice. Got a Pepsi Max. That's good. He'll be needing that. Now, we do need to save this village, and we do need to make... Oh, shit, Gab, no. Gab, please, please. Okay, he didn't rape himself. Whew. Okay, thank God. Jesus Christ. This hack is giving me fucking a heart attack. Alright, let's go. Let's go rescue, or let's go recruit Gab. So, I'll need to get some swords. We'll get a double sword. I actually bought a lot of swords with Jagan. I am questioning my life decisions right now. I hope that I didn't spend too much of my money. Not really sure if I should be using devil swords at all, actually. I'm starting to think it may not be such a good idea. But yeah, I think I'm gonna occupy the fort with Jagan. Let's just equip the iron sword for now. Should we... Do we have enough for a devil lance? We should probably buy... Oh, that's right, we can give France Reavers away. We should probably do that. Yeah, that probably isn't a bad idea at all. Also, we gotta remember to visit the villages. Alright, there we go. I really don't like the ranger sword animation. I gotta say, I think the ranger sword animation looks wonky at best, and their horse looks retarded. There's just something about their retarded horse that looks really, really fucking weird. Now, you can see how weak Jagan is with an iron sword. The reason why he does a lot of damage is because steel swords are really OP in this Pikmin edits. Alright. Let's dump off Dorcas right here. Okay, we can go visit some villages with Belle. Or we can... Well, also, potentially, we can kill some brigands with her. We could go and visit the village with Marcus. Now, I do have a... Did I do this support already? Yes, I did. I'm guessing we can attack this brigand. Maybe we can do some damage to him. Nope. Oh, no. Amelia died again. okay. What if we come in with... Yeah, there we go. Unless he crits. Ah, fuck, he crits. Yeah, boss win with his 15% innate crit rate will crit a lot. That's a problem. It's gonna be difficult to just give kills away casually. Of course, the more phantoms you summon, the more experience Amelia is gonna get. So summoning phantoms is gonna be very good for Amelia. Come to think of it, we need to visit these villages because I want that red gem. I already spent all my money. This is going really well. Good job, Amelia. I think she gets doubled. No, she doesn't. Now, what's the con of her phantoms like, I wonder? I actually have to check. What is the con of her phantoms? They have 11 con? What the fuck? Alright, there we go. Dad! Dorcas! What happened to your Dorcas? Did you eat the mutton again, Dorcas? Alright, trust no one. Not even your father. Alright, so we got the Geb. The rape axe is insanely dangerous. Do not use it. Like, unless you have to. You already saw how much it can fuck you over. I think we're gonna stick with the steel axe for now. Alright, let's see. Oh, Belle. Alright, I do believe Belle has a pretty fast support with Boulder. Doesn't Vanessa have a support with Boulder in the vanilla gameplay? I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure that's the case. So I'm definitely going to be building my supports while I before I pull bone. As I said, he... Oh, shit! No. Get the fuck out of there. We do not want to be pulling bone. Because we want to be grinding some supports before we do that. You actually get a pure water, which is... it's going to be more useful than you may think. It's actually going to be very useful. Alright, there we go. And let's go visit the village. And yes, you did just see Selena. Her head is a little bit too small for her body, but still, this is an amazing portrait done by Calvin right here. That gives us a red gem, which is very nice. I'm gonna keep Franz around this ruin, I think. He can deal with this brigand from this ruin. Rap bop ba 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 da ba da ba da ba da ba. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh! I did not think Bone would be in range of Gab. I'm an idiot. Can I get away from Bone? I'm not sure if Bone keeps attacking you if you exit his range. Okay, this is bad. I think I can get out of his range. Dorcas, get the fuck out of there. Yeah, I think if I just run, Because Bone has pocket wings, which means he can fly. Which is scary. Alright, I'm gonna do this now. Go, Bell. Get a crit. Bell's crit animation is really cool. Her dodge animation is cool, too. Maybe I shouldn't waste a rapier. I know you get multiple rapiers, though, so it's not a massively big deal. Maybe we should just kill this guy. Let's just kill this guy. Ah, Brigands gets a lot of avoidance in mountains. Let's see if Bone stays put or not. Does he stay put, or does he come after us once we engage him? The most exciting battle ever. Nope, he stays put. That's great. That means we can work on some supports. Alright, thanks for the mountain view. Alright, that probably means we can give this kill to Bell. I'm gonna use the rapier again just because I like getting kills. I wanna see her crit. So I'm gonna build a very quick support between Geb and Dorcas. It's a good one because they both have the fire affinity, which is really good. Alright, so yeah, I'll be right back after I've done these supports. Alright, so let's pop some supports. It's kind of fun to read these. I'm not going to do it, but it's actually hilarious to read these supports. You know, when they're altered. They're not really altered, but this one's particularly funny. It's like, hi, Dad! It's funny to see Dorcas and Geb's father-son relationship evolving. Alright, I do believe that's all the supports we get for now. Okay, so I'm just gonna pull Bone with Jagan. And I'm gonna show off the might of the Silverlands. We bought all the equipment we need, we visited all the villages, so we should be good. Yes, you can see, the Silverlands is very solid. Urg Blast! And that gives Jagan a level up, which is very nice. Hit point, 2 hit points actually, and he got 2 points of luck, which is very nice. And that is this map dealt with. Hold on a moment, aren't you the great Geb? You fought for an A. Oh, the great Geb. Oh. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be enough for now. But before that happens, we get a little bit of a flashback. And we get to see Mary Sue. Oh my god. It's so good. My god. Everyone who likes traps is going to be so excited about this one. Oh my god. So good. And of course, we get a little bit of a sneak peek of something else right now. It's Jafar! Alright, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you guys enjoyed this first part. As I said, if you clicked on this the moment it came out, chances are the ROM is not going to be available for download just yet. It'll be coming out in a couple of hours. I'll be notifying everyone on Discord as soon as it comes out. And the next episode will come out tomorrow. I hope you guys have enjoyed this a lot. Again, big shout out to Datagne, my beta testers, as well as Mina for designing the thumbnail. Thank you so much. I could not have done this without you. And yeah, I'm having heaps of fun with this Let's Play already. I can already tell this is going to be a great one. And I hope you guys will have equally as much fun as I have playing this ROM. Let me know in the comment section what difficulty you're going to be playing on. What characters you look forward to using. What route you plan on taking. Yeah, let me hear about it. Any specific characters you're excited to see? And what characters do you think I should end up using? Depending on, you can go and read up on them in the Google Doc, so let me know. And yeah, make sure to head into the Fire Emblem 8 Pick My Edits channel and share your experiences. Post lots of screenshots, please. I want to see lots of screenshots from your experiences, what kind of units you're using and so forth. If you see some funny things. And of course, should there be the occasional bugs, you can report them as well. We're not going to be bothering fixing minor graphical glitches or something, but if there are bugs that makes the game unplayable, please report them to us. I think we found most of them, but there might still be some bugs left for all I know. Hopefully not going to be too many though. But yeah, until next time, give this video a like and a comment, please. It does help out a lot, and do click the bell for notifications. And yeah, my name is Manx, and I'll see you again tomorrow. Goodbye!